Good morning, student. Last time you have studied the exterior angle theorem, which says that is the remote interior angle theorem. Many of the students they are sending, they sent me the answers of that exercise, practice it. Okay, that is very good thing. But some students they are till they not sending, and when we'll check your notebook, okay. So all things should be written in your notebook. So that's why I'm telling those who not written that, complete that one. You have to see the LMS system, learning management system. Already I uploaded all the videos in that one, and that record is come. How many students seen that videos and what time they seen? 1 hour, 2 hour, whatever be. So that record is there. So some student did not open that LMS also. See, please open it and see that all the videos. Okay, and complete that whole syllabus. Now we'll see next point. This is the test of congruency. Already last time also you have studied. Just revision part. So we will see the definitions of that. That is also you have to write in your notebook. So four tests are there. First one is ASA test. So ASA test means angle side angle test. Okay, angle side angle means in between two angles, one side interior. Okay, see this angle B is congruent to angle Q. Same symbol. C is congruent to angle R, and in between these two angles, one side, the corresponding sides of that two triangles are congruent. Such a type of these two triangles are there, then they are congruent by which test? ASA test, angle side angle test. Second one is SAS, ASA, SAS, side angle side. Now two sides and included angle. See, two sides included angle, two sides included angle. If two sides and this angle, then that is not SAS test. Okay, so SAS test means that angle should be in between two sides. ASA means that side should be in between two angles. Here in between two angles. If this two angle and this side, then that is not, there is no ASA test. That triangles are not congruent. So you see, by SAS, two sides, this side congruent to this, corresponding sides, this one congruent to this, and included angle also congruent. That's why this element is congruent to PQR by side angle side test. Third is side test. So now your corresponding sides are congruent. See, same symbol indicates that sides are congruent. Here two lines, here these two lines, here one, here three lines means that sides are congruent. Means PR is congruent to XY, PQ one line is congruent to this YX or XY like this. So now these two triangles are congruent by SAS. And another one is for applicable only right angle triangle. Here see, these do both to our right angle triangle. And if in the right angle triangle, hypotenuse, opposite of 90 is hypotenuse. If hypotenuse and one side, any one side of that corresponding two triangles, right angle triangles are congruent, then these two triangles are congruent by hypotenuse side test. By hypotenuse, many of the students in exam they see here, these two congruent is angle 90-90, they written SAS. This is not SAS. SAS means two sides and included angle. These two sides, included angle, this one, not this one. So if right angle triangle, then there is a hypotenuse side test. So two example will see, very simple exercise. I will send photocopy. You have to solve remaining exam.